If this is your first time here and you want to know a little bit more about movies, make sure you hit that subscribe button and hit the bell notification so you don't miss anything here at Movie Nerds.
Hey everyone, Trent here from Movie Nerds, back with another review. I've just come from seeing Agatha Christie's classic novel come back to life on the big screen, Murder on the Orient Express, with director Kenneth Branagh attached to the film as well as starring, my goodness. So, is it a fantastic movie as we come to expect from Sir Kenneth? Or is it the murder mystery that kind of fizzles out and is boring and droll? Stay tuned to find out.
I see evil on this train. A passenger has died.
So they got him after all.
You assume he was killed?
No, not. Well, he was in perfectly good health. He had his enemies.
Indeed, he was murdered.
God, murder here.
God rest his soul.
Someone was rummaging around my cabin in the middle of the night. No one would listen to me.
If there was a murder...
What is going on?
Then there was a murderer. The murderer is with us.
And every one of you is a suspect.
And who are you?
My name is Hercule Poirot, and I am probably the greatest detective in the world.
Okay, so the basic premise of the movie, we've got fantastic world-renowned detective, superstar, Hercule Poirot. Hercule Poirot, not the one that fights lions, the detective. Going on a case for in Istanbul, and he wants a nice relaxing holiday, so to get back to London he's going to take the Orient Express. Unfortunately, some people have nefarious purposes on that train, and a murder is committed. So, it's up to the world's greatest detective to reluctantly solve the crime, and figure out which of the 12 people are suspects in the murder. So, is it any good? In short, yes. It's a fantastic movie. Beautiful cinematography, excellent acting, an all-star cast. There's too many actors to name, so I'm going to summarise some of them. There's Michelle Pfeiffer, Dame Judi Dench, Willem Dafoe, Daisy Ridley, Kenneth Branagh, Johnny Depp. Oh, I could go on. There's just that many big names attached to this film, and it pays off. While they could have easily spent the budget on getting these big name actors, they actually bring something really unique and fantastic to the parts they play. While some of them get more screen time than actors, obviously the bigger name actors are going to get more screen time, some are kind of shoved to the side and not overly necessary. But the best thing is Kenneth Branagh as Poirot. He's amazing. He brings something different to the character that I've not seen before. He brings a physicality to the character that I didn't really like when he's chasing Josh Gad down the train quarry steps. That was a bit too over the top, but He brings the presence and he brings humor. There's so much dry wit in this film that you would think that Poirot is kind of a jerk, but I relate to him so much. I love him as a person. He doesn't like people. He likes dessert. He doesn't like talking about business when he's having dessert, and he likes to be left alone. Oh, me in a nutshell. Anyway, a lot of the jokes and a lot of the humor was really, really well done. If that wasn't in there, the movie might have been a bit slow and a bit boring and a bit droll, but it brought life to the character, and it kind of really showed the key to his psyche and how he worked. Like, he used humor as a diffusing mechanism to get his different interview tactics and interrogation tactics, make the interrogation feel, you know, comfortable so that people spoke. Every other actor, really good. They brought something to their roles. Each played a different, unique part. Some actors weren't necessarily needed. Willem Dafoe was an exceptional waste of a talented actor. He didn't really do much. And there are a few on-the-nose moments involving social justice and diversity within the film, like alluding to stereotyping and the mistreatment, that I don't think was needed. It didn't need to be a politically agenda-driven film. But thankfully, these were few and far between. And it was actually quite beneficial to bring into something that's not often explored in kind of racial issues in the 1940s post-war. But It was a fantastic film. The cinematography was excellent. We had some beautiful set pieces involving the Orient Express traveling through Istanbul and going through the mountains, the snowy mountains. And yeah, a lot of it did look a bit digitized at some points, but you're not going to get that in a period piece. Obviously, it's going to be make-believe and fictional in what they're showing. But I just wish they took a bit more time to render some of the images so they didn't look as CGI as they did. Johnny Depp is fantastic. He pretty much just has to play himself at this point. So does Judi Dench. Unfortunately, the problem with the movie is they are speaking in foreign languages. Well, not foreign languages, but they have accents. And a lot of the actors are English or American. So they're not really going to be playing the French or the Belgium or any kind of accent really well, because they slip. Judi Dench slips up quite a fair bit, and she just discards the accent altogether. And if you're a director, I wouldn't be telling Judi Dench to pick up the accent again. I wouldn't want to face her at all. It'd be scary as hell. But it is highly entertaining and really enjoyable. They do really well considering they don't actually speak the tongue. And Kenneth Branagh, even though he slips up, he has a really, really good accent, and you can tell he's having a lot of fun, which translates to the crowd and watching it, because he's always got this cheeky little smile. But he doesn't actually have to display much, because he's got this awesome moustache. So I kind of have grown a beard now to emulate it, but he's got this awesome moustache that conveys so much emotion. All he has to do is look, and all this emotion is going through the screen. And as an actor who is also directing, that's fantastic, because you don't need to give direction. And there's one scene where he has this cool little moustache protector when he's sleeping. So it is quite humorous, but it is still a very serious movie. And it all revolves around the plot of solving this murder. One of the main issues I had with the movie, the first two thirds were fantastic, but then the final 30 or 40 minutes seemed far too coincidental. Things happened, I'm not going to go into spoilers, but events happened, and it got to a point where they ran out of interrogating tactics and clues and all these little red herrings, and you kind of guessed what was going to happen when a certain event happened. And yeah, not going to go into spoilers, but I didn't like the easy way out they took. I mean, this is the world's greatest detective. He should be able to solve any case, and there shouldn't be any type of moral ambiguity. But yeah, it does differ from the books and the previous movies, but majority of it, fantastic. I just wish they were a bit more strong in their confidence in finishing off that final act. But fantastic movie. They could have improved from what they did in the trailer. In the trailer, it got me really excited because they had a very Sherlock-esque kind of bubbles popping up whenever Poirot was addressing or walking past a certain character that said their name, what they were, their role. It was very Cluedo-y. And I think that would have done really, really well coming into this movie, because it would have minimized the exposition that was needed. Like, it all centralized around this one event, and instead of recounting that event time and time again and giving all these different little clues, having that visually up there, it would have cut out a lot of needless talking, and it would have given the audience something else to look at when you were getting distracted by a lot of the difficult phrases they were saying with the accent. But minor gripes, nitpicking, I really enjoyed the movie. I highly recommend you go see it. Murder of the Orient Express, Agatha Christie's latest tale, is out in Australian cinemas this Thursday. This Thursday, people. So make sure you go and see it. Let us know what you think of it in the comments below. And once again, my name's Trent. You're watching Movie Nerds. Until next time, see you then.